The benefits of the glider, a private pilot glider rating can be had in as little as 10 hours. The FAA requirement is 10 hours. I've never trained anybody that quickly, but I've had several that have done it in 15 or 16 hours of flight training, total time. Average cost to get a private pilot glider rating is about $5,000. That includes your check ride, your study materials, all your ground school, and your flight training. A glider is an aircraft that is designed so that it can be flown with the power off. And I don't know if you can see, you probably can, but this prop looks like a normal prop, but when we get up there and shut the motor down, we pull a knob on the panel and it does this, okay? And we call that feathering. But the glide ratio improves by about 10% when we do that. So it makes a big difference. It's a very streamlined aircraft. It accelerates quickly, and it gets off the ground in about 300 to 400 feet, and then you climb at over 1,000 feet a minute on 80 horsepower. And we do have some electric aircraft coming out now. We have an electric Taurus, which uses the same wing as this one. But that's made for the purist, the guy who really wants to go up and soar and turn the motor off. We also have an electric Alpha Trainer. It's not yet approved by the FAA, but it should happen anytime. We're hoping this year. And the Alpha Trainer will really revolutionize flight schools for normal airplane training. My love, though, is the glider side of things. If you've got a glider rating, all those hours count toward an airplane rating. So it gives you a quick way to start flying and an inexpensive way to use your rating in a glider and count the hours that you've flown towards your airplane rating. This is an LSA, and the factory would have to approve it for IFR. This will not. We do offer a 100 horsepower experimental version that also is registered as a glider, and if it's equipped properly and the pilot is properly trained and current, he can fly in IFR conditions. Now, these are 700-800 pound aircraft, empty weight. They're not really designed for heavy IFR, and we don't want anybody even trying to do that. But if for somebody needs to get through a layer of clouds and they're already got an IFR rating, the Pipistrel Verus SW with 100 horsepower is ideal as an IFR platform. We've had a few young folks. I'd like to get a lot more young folks because I think they're missing something that's a lot of fun. The majority of my customers, though, are older, probably already pilots, have lost a medical, and that's the unique thing about a glider. A glider, whether it's an experimental glider, an LSA glider, or a type certified glider, the pilot does not need a medical. And even if they failed a medical, as long as they can look in a mirror and they're not on prohibited medications and they can say, I feel good, I'm safe to fly, they can fly the glider. And that's not the case with other light sports. From September through May, it's beautiful here in Florida. If you want the thrill of a lifetime, we'll go out and do some wingovers. And Mike seemed to enjoy the wingover. But if you want to get your rating, come during the cooler months and it'll be more fun. But for an average of about $5,000, you can get a private pilot glider rating with a self-launch endorsement and have all those hours count toward an airplane rating if you want an airplane rating on top.